Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Today is Friday, January 13th, 2012. Hi, welcome to Live and Local, and I am your hostess, Francine Starr. First, a question from my audience. Dear Francine, will you ever show your face on YouTube? Well, no, I won't. I'm a female, and I really don't want all of America knowing what exactly I look like. That couldn't be safe for me, you know. As you can see, my subscribers, Know My Plant For Me, his URL is right here in the box, wants to fight with us. Fine. I will leave his chicken scrabble comments up for all to see. I made a video response to his misguided complaints written below and on the comments on my homepage, titled, Shocking Ron Paul Against Civil Rights Explained. Now, I want to type this out one at a time for the hearing impaired, but it's really long, so I'm going to do best I can. Plan is saying, Ron Paul is an enemy to Israel. In this one statement, we can clearly see where Plant's priorities are, namely Zionist Israel. And I will open with, Ron Paul wants to cut foreign aid to everyone, including Israel. We are broke, America. Cutting foreign aid to Israel's war machine is what is making Plant mad at Ron Paul. That's the singular issue, pretty much. Then, let's see here, Ron Paul stating for this cause, we do not have a treaty with Israel. If we're going to be at war, we need congressional approval. Paul would like to be friendly and open up fair trade with everyone. Paul believes allies should be treated equally. At one time, Israel and Palestine were living together on one land at peace with each other. Then, one day, the Israeli government changed, and so did ours, into a violent, power-hungry war machine with intent to take over the entire Middle East and the rest of the world. Unfortunately, our government is also allying with globalization of one government. That's Nazi activity. Isn't that what the Nazis did, children? I really don't know. I missed that class. I was busy. Anyway, today Israel has made war with just about every nation in the area. It is Israel provoking all of them and us. Even the Orthodox Jewish people hate Israel for its exceedingly violent human rights crimes, racial cleansing, and genocide of the Palestinians. Prior to 2006, Bush predecessors signed numerous executive orders which allows the federal government to seize control of everything, and I mean everything, from the food to toilet paper, from schools to railroads, and all emergency outlets. Please, let's take a moment out and read the following executive orders, which I will list here and a URL. I'm going to read some of them, though. I'm just going to, you know, breeze over some of them because you can click the URL or copy the URL to go read them yourself. Executive Order 10990 allows the government to take over all modes of transportation and control of highways and seaports. 10995 allows the government to seize control of the communications and the media, and that means all of that. 10997 allows the government to take over all electrical powers, all powers, gas, petroleum, fuels, and minerals. 10998 allows the government to seize all means of transportation, including personal cars, trucks, vehicles, and any kind. In total, control over all of our highways, seaports, and waterways. 10999 allows the government to take control over all food resources and farms. 11000 allows the government to mobilize civilians to work in brigades under government army supervision. 11002 designates the postmaster, the post office, to operate as a national registration for of all persons. That means the post office has to turn our information over to government so they can track us. Order number 11003 allows the government to take over all airports, aircrafts, including commercial aircraft and private planes. 11004 allows the government and finance authority to relocate communities. That's entire communities, people. Build new housing in abandoned areas and put us in there against our will and force us to work for them. Executive Order 11005 allows the government to take control over the railroads, inland waterways, and public storage facilities. 11051 allows the responsibility of the Office of Emergency Planning and gives authorization to put all executive orders into effect. 11310 grants the authority to the Department of Justice to enforce all them things on us. 11049 assigns emergency preparedness function to federal department agencies, consolidating all 21 executive orders. 11921 allows the Federal Emergency Preparedness Agency, known as FEMA, to develop plans to establish control over the mechanisms of production, distribution of energy sources, wages, salary, credit, and the flow of money in the United States financial institutions and in any undefined national emergency. Anyway, now I'm scared, and you should be too. For our children, go to the URL provided and investigate these executive orders yourself. Around 2006, President Bush seized and took control of FEMA. FEMA is not the same agency anymore. In 2009, Obama strips us of our 22nd Amendment, which mandates a presidential term no longer than 8 years. The United States is now in danger of one ruler for a lifetime. On 12/31/2011, Obama has signed into law that American citizens can be held in FEMA prisons without probable cause, without a trial, and keep us locked up forever. In January 8, 2012, the Obama administration declares Occupy Wall Street protesters and a whole slew of other peaceful protesters as terrorists. Basically, anyone henceforth that is brave enough to speak up against the tyrants in the federal government will be classified as terrorists. Wake up, America. It is not too late to take our country back. And I'm going to scream. Scream! Vote for the defender of the Constitution, Ron Paul, or die in FEMA camps.